Welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here for the Keep Productive YouTube channel. This video will be a useful guide to embracing filters with context inside of a task management application. Now, this methodology can be replicated in tools like TickTick and Todoist and many more that have a filtering ability. And what we'll be talking about is something that is mentioned in the book Getting Things Done by David Allen, giving you some tips of how to craft filters to find tasks easily and manage them much more suitably during your workday. Now, today's video is sponsored by SaneBox. We'll share a little bit more about them later. So this video was inspired after a recent office hours I did with Todoist, and actually nested inside of the course called GTD in 21 days, or well, at least it's called GTD Like a Boss. That is produced by Tiago Forte. I'll include that link in description. Now, the goal is so that when you open your filters, it brings in relevant tasks that are built around scenarios that you can essentially build based on your own situation. Now, if you're using Todoist, in which I'm using for this video, you do need Todoist Premium to access the labels and filters. There's a smashing quote that I think we should start with from David Allen, which is, "You have more to do than you can possibly do. You just need to feel good about your choices." And it's definitely something that relates in this context. So the first thing that you should do is set labels. Now, there's loads of different context points you could add. We'll start with a couple of them that may inspire you, and you don't have to use them all. You can cherry pick which ones you like, but let's get started. So the first one could be energy levels. Energy levels could be anything from inactive to active to proactive, and that could describe the energy levels that you have. So for example, the other day I felt super inactive, which means I didn't really have much energy to complete the tasks at hand. I don't really want much brain power in an inactive state. So for example, I may associate administration, an email task, to an inactive label. Or, for example, proactive could be something where you're going quite deep. So that could be a deep step work state piece of work. For example, that could be editing in my case, or for you, it could be something quite intense like designing, could be producing something that takes longer than an hour, and that could be a proactive energy state. So energy state is a great way to start, and you can label things with inactive, active, and proactive, or you can actually just give your energy levels a low, medium, or high. The next one is time to complete the task. Some applications do actually provide you with the ability to add duration, but in this case, for example, apps like TickTick and Todoist don't. So you may want to add anything from 5 minutes to 10 minutes to 15 minutes to 30 minutes to 60 minutes, and some people add just 60 minutes plus. Next up is what you actually need to use to complete that task. And some tasks can be done on mobile, some tasks need to be done on desktop, some tasks need to be done with a phone, and other tasks can be done just using a certain computer or a certain software. So you can include devices and tools to the completion of that task. And this will come in later, but those context points can be useful, for example, when you're setting up these filters, because you can be very specific about what tools you have at that current time. The next is location. You may want to say whether it's in the house or out of the house, and you may just want to keep it like that, or you may actually want to have home, office, different rooms that you do work in, so that you can associate a certain task to each room, especially if you're working from home. That's a really effective technique. So location can be an important one. The next one could be people. If you don't necessarily want to add somebody to inside of your tasks or within your task management application, then people can be a great way. So adding a label for the people you work with or your friends and family could actually help you to add some depth to a task about who you need to specifically talk to get those tasks done. And finally, if you're looking to add an extra layer of importance to a task over the top of something like the P1, P2, P3 in Todoist, which are used to help define the priority of a task, you can add an urgency context point label, which, for example, in this case might be low, medium, or high. Or if you don't want them to clash with your energy levels, it could be very important, burning, or you could create a little sort of urgency system from yourself, and that could be a good way to layer a level of urgency over the top of your labels. So now you've got to go ahead and create those labels, and that's a good starting point, and you can add whatever you find suitable, and you can always add more later on. Just before we move on to actually building the filters, a little bit more about SaneBox. SaneBox is a powerful way to triage your email inbox, and you can find out more about it below. Here's a little bit more about them. These days we get inundated with emails, so it seems it's no longer about responding to them all, but the ones that truly matter. And that's why you need to check out SaneBox. I've personally been using SaneBox for the last 2 years and have loved the way that the AI monitors my inbox, moving any unwanted emails right into a folder called Sane Later, leaving me more time to focus on processing emails that are important and not every single one that comes in. Apparently, SaneBox users save roughly 3 to 4 hours a week on email. What's really cool is you can train the system as well, so if you find an email in the wrong folder, just move it and it will train over time. There's no installs, no learning, and it works with all email providers and services out there. I personally use it with Missive. It also has some nifty features like Sane Black Hole, where you can drag messages from annoying senders you never want to hear from again, and Sane Reminders to ping you if someone hasn't replied to your email by a certain date. Now you can get a 2-week free trial and $25 credit by visiting sanebox.com/keepproductive. Anyway folks, a big thank you and I hope you enjoy. So the second step is to set these filters up to scenario map, and of course you may have different scenarios, different situations that are going on, and these labels should help you to build those little situations. So of course, I always recommend grabbing a piece of paper for this or something like this, because you just want to be able to sketch out a few ideas. But think of different situations you are in throughout your workday. You may actually want to draw a 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. sort of bit of an outline of what you typically do. For example, a lot of people do administration in the mornings when they get to their desk. Can there be a filter built around that? And also situations like travel, like on the way to work, do you typically do work tasks or do you leave that to yourself? And when you get home, do you have certain tasks you do when you come into the house? So being able to find scenarios that are typically routinely happen throughout your day, then that's something that can really help you. And for example, it's also looking at the low and high points of the day. If you want, you can draw a little sort of line graph of how much energy you see going across your day. A lot of people dip before lunchtime because their energy levels, you know, after a bit of food, they tend to get a bit more energy after that, and then sort of die down, or their productivity dies down later in the day. So you could potentially build some scenarios off of that or use some labels based on that. So think about a few scenarios. I've got three that we can demonstrate here that may be helpful to be able to pinpoint some tasks and build some scenarios. So the first scenario you could have is the commute. Now, if you wanted to get some tasks done on the way to work, if you have a commute, then this could be a useful filter to set you up with that. For example, the energy levels could be inactive or low, in order to set a sort of low precedent to what you're doing, because you may want to just be sort of getting to work, not necessarily doing a very intense task. You may not have the tools. And you also want to add the devices as, for example, a mobile phone, or if it's something you need to do the laptop there. You may also want to add the time to complete only tasks that are 5 minutes or 10 minutes to complete, because your commute may be just 30 minutes with some partial walking. And also you can add the location as out as well. So those energy levels will help you to fine tune some tasks to actually populate your main filter. And that's quite helpful because you can click in that and every single morning and you can see those tasks that you could actually get done on the way to work. The second scenario could be ones that when you start your deep work state can be really just set off. For example, these could be ones that have that high level of urgency and require a higher level of energy to complete. And the ones that are also time to complete longer than 60 minutes and that may actually require you to have a MacBook or be inside of the office. So you can actually use that filter to help produce a deep work state. And finally, one more that can help if you're using this as a way to manage every aspect of your life. For example, if you get home and your partner's not home for another hour, or you have a little bit of free time, 30 minutes, or you want to get settled into the home lifestyle, of course, it's different coming from work. You can definitely do maybe 20 minutes of clearing the house. So you could, for example, add energy levels as medium, things that can be done in 5 minutes, and also location as home, and that's all you need for that, and they can always bring in those items. But if you want to be very specific, you could label those ones as house chores in the tags area or the labels area to really be efficient on getting them done. So you have three useful scenarios there, and it's definitely worth thinking up some of the scenarios that you have to do. And you can nest these all inside of the lists areas, the projects, and tuck them underneath so that, for example, if you want to produce more results in those periods of time, they can be done like that. So definitely have a think about your scenarios. Hopefully this was useful, and we may be doing more of these sort of tutorials and demonstrations. So if you have any comments about what else you'd like to learn in terms of GTD and things like that, maybe we'll do some short lessons that can be applied to your own situation. So folks, a big thank you, and hopefully you find this useful. Please do make sure you subscribe and check out all the links in the description. All right, folks, cheerio.